you guys are all doing good. So in this series of videos, we'll try to have paper discussion from AIIMS July 2020 session. I've been getting several requests, so I felt like why not? Why not consider your requests and then have these paper discussion videos in YouTube? So some of you have contributed to certain keywords based on the questions which appeared in the exam. And I encourage all of you, those who are watching this video, to come up with more keywords related to the questions of this recently concluded AIIMS exam in the comment section below. I will review them and I'll try to present them in subsequent parts of this paper discussion video series, right? So I hope you guys are ready. So let's start with our first question. And before I start, I wanted to highlight this. See, the objective of this paper discussion videos is to make sure that we are trying to focus on related topics so that if at all there is a question from these particular topics, you should be able to answer them with confidence, right? So let's keep that as our primary objective rather than merely trying to find out the right answer for the questions which appeared in the exam, okay? So here is the first question. So there seems to be a question on allergic potential of various irrigating solutions. And as you can see, we have several irrigating solutions, and in Engel, they have presented a table with various materials and their allergic potential. And you can clearly see that sodium hypochlorite has allergic potential, including chlorhexidine and povidone iodine. Whereas hydrogen peroxide, EDTA and citric acid seems to be having no allergic potential. And also keep in mind that iodine and sodium hypochlorite, that is povidone iodine and sodium hypochlorite, these are both halogen releasing agents and they attack common key protein groups, right? So this is some information pertaining to various irrigating solutions and their allergic potential. So let me know what the question is in specific. I'm sure you'll get the answer based on the available information, or if you need any elaboration, do let me know. I'll try to address that either in the comment section or in the description part of this video. Okay, now let's move on to the next question, sensitivity. So what's the definition of sensitivity? Just remember tendron percussion. So TOP, tendron percussion, sensitiveness. So just keep this as a mnemonic. So sensitivity is true positive by true positive plus false negative. Whereas specificity is true negative by true negative plus false positive. So these are the formulae of sensitivity and specificity. And if you go by the meaning of the same, sensitivity is the ability of a test to identify correctly those who have the disease, that is true positive. Whereas specificity is the ability of a test to identify correctly those who do not have the disease, that is true negative. Okay, so I hope it's clear. Now let's move on to the next question, ratio of width to height of maxillary central incisor. So anyways, the dimensions of permanent teeth or deciduous teeth, so try to memorize them or at least try to have an approximation of the values pertaining to these dimensions. And if you're thorough with the same, you can answer any question related to this. So ratio of width to height of maxillary central incisor, so if you consider the mesiodistal dimension of central incisor, maxillary central, it's around 8.5, whereas the height of the length of the crown is around 10.5. So if you divide 8.5 to 10.5, you'll get an approximate value of 0.8. okay, so consider this table very, very important and see to that you memorize the same, at least a dimension of one tooth per day for the next 15 days or 20 days or 30 days maximum. You'll be mastering all these values. Okay, I hope it's clear. And you can of course use visualization technique in order to master these numericals. Now let's move on to the next question. So we have certain criteria like grade 2 or grade 3 furcation and poor systemic conditions, intra-bony pocket. So these are some of the keywords which I received, and it seems like they've asked you, what's the prognosis? Is it poor, questionable, hopeless, or a fail? So if you refer Carranza, we have a classification. One scheme gives us the following classification, that is good prognosis, fair prognosis, poor prognosis, questionable prognosis, and hopeless prognosis. So hopeless is where there is inadequate attachment to maintain health, comfort, and function. Questionable prognosis is where there is more than 50% detachment loss, poor crown to root ratio, poor root form, class 2 furcations or class 3 furcations, along with which, if the mobility is more than grade 2, and also route proximity, right? So these are some of the criteria for questionable prognosis. Poor prognosis, 50% detachment clause, class 2 for patient involvement. And fair prognosis, it's approximately 25% detachment clause and or class 1 for patient involvement. Good prognosis, control of etiological factors and adequate periodontal support, ensuring the tooth is easy to maintain by clinician and most importantly by the patient, right? So this is one scheme classifying prognosis into various categories, right? So see what the question is and if this particular explanation helps you answer that specific question. Or else let me know. As I mentioned, I'll update relevant information in the description part of this video. And moving to the final question of this particular video, epsilon phase in amalgam refers to which of the following? So we have various phase symbols and composition as given in Phillips, which we discussed several times in our study club as well as in our A-classes, including test series. So we have gamma, which represents AG3SN, gamma 1 AG2HG3, gamma 2 SN78HG, epsilon CU3SN, eta CU6SN5. So these are various symbols and stoichiometry of phases. Consider this a very, very important. It's only by making notes and through repetition you can master these memory based topics, right? I hope it's clear. So these are some of the select topics or select keywords which I received initially. I still have few more keywords, and in the process of referring and reviewing literature, in the meantime I want you to let me know additional keywords in the comments below. As I said, I'll try reviewing them as well and I'll present them in the subsequent videos. And before I conclude, let me remind you the objective of these sessions. It's to make sure that we're touching relevant topics based on this keyword so that this process of discussion helps you in the upcoming exams, including AIIMS, PGI, NEET MDS, etc. So for any further queries or assistance, you're more than welcome to get back through mail at proudtobedentist@gmail.com. So wish you all the best. Love you all.